What's going on, everybody? It's Andy Kuba, and today I'm finally going to do my 10,000 subscriber Q&A special thing. Now, of course, I was planning to do it a few weeks back, but the main reason why I couldn't do it was because of work. My schedule was terrible, it still is, but now I have a 4-day break. I have the time to do it, so I'm not gonna waste your time anymore. Let's get this started. Will I be in the video? Yes. Yes, you will. Do you plan on ever using Sceptile in Pokken? To be honest, dude, nah. I mean, okay. The reason why I don't have any other interest in the other characters is because out of all the characters, my second favorite Pokemon of all time is in the game, which is Blaziken. And ever since the game was announced as Pokken Fighters, actually before that, when it was showcased after, I believe it was a trailer showing all of the Pokemon games leading up to X and Y actually, and then we saw like that little snippet of Lucario and Blaziken, I said instantly, I don't care what the game is, Blaziken's my main. So I actually don't have any other plans to use any other character besides Blaziken. What's your favorite game series from growing up? That's actually a really tough one, holy crap. It's either probably Kingdom Hearts or probably like the Dragon Ball Z Tenkaichi series. One of those two, because I'm tripping. Okay, no. It's either Kingdom Hearts, one of the Tenkaichi games, or Smash, because that's one thing that I played heavy when I was a kid was Smash, especially Melee. But yeah, it's one of those three. I can't really decide because I had a lot of fun with all of them. But yeah, just one of those three games. They were absolute power. Have you seen My Hero Academia? Yes, I have actually. I honestly think it's a fantastic anime. Like, it seems like it's going to lead up to something amazing. Oh my lord, like I'm actually really enjoying it. I don't want to say any like spoilers because there's only 4 episodes out right now and I'm pretty sure that some people probably haven't seen it yet, but it's a fantastic anime. I would recommend it to anybody. So if you're trying to find something to watch, go watch My Hero Academia. It's flames, bro, flames. How did you build your channel? How did you meet all these other YouTubers? Well, to be honest, how I built my channel, that's actually a really good question. Like, I guess like when my channel really started to pop off was when I started doing like Dragon Ball Z content on my channel, because I did content before, but that was just for fun. Like once Battle of Z came out, one, I got it because it came out on my birthday, and two, because it was a Dragon Ball Z game and I was really passionate about actually starting to get into YouTube. So at the time I wasn't really growing because my channel was small. If I'm not mistaken, I only had 100 subs. And then around February of that month, I met Rhyme, and Rhyme had 5,000 subs at the time. And we were talking, we were chilling, and we did a lot of collabs together. And I think around that time is when my channel started to pop off. But yeah, so I guess everybody thank Rhyme Style for helping me out, even like back in the day, like when he had 5,000 subs and I had 100. But yes. Dang, how long ago was that too? That was 2 years ago. That's crazy. But yeah. Inukuba, I like your videos and want to become a YouTuber like you. You're really cool, but you're ugly as F. I'm just being honest. You ain't lying. Have you ever watched a DJ Killer Fox parody? Sorry, bro, I haven't. I'm gonna be honest, I haven't. Congrats on reaching 10K subs. Congrats on reaching 10K subs. I started watching your channel because you're the only YouTuber that mains Blaziken and Pokken and is actually good. My question, how long did it take you to memorize that outro? Woo! Bruh, I don't know. The thing about me is that, one thing that people actually think is that I script everything, and that's actually not the case. When it comes to me, I can't go off of scripts. Like, I freestyle everything. Like right now, like this Q&A session, I'm freestyling it. Everything, like my commentary, my intro, my outro, everything is freestyled. But the thing is, of course, like I need an intro and I need an outro. So at the time, I just started like thinking of things that I can say in my outro to get people to, you know, like my video, subscribe to my channel, share the video, you know, things like that. And it eventually just became like a thing. Like it became like second nature to me. Like, so like anytime like I do a video, like my intro just comes in naturally, my outro just comes in naturally, and it just goes from there. How long did it take you to grow the fro afro? Hope you get to 15K. That's actually a good question. I think right now I've been growing this afro for, let's see, when I left my home city, that was in 20, 14? I forgot. But if I'm not mistaken, I've been growing my afro for almost 2 years now. I think like a year and a half, 2 years. How you guys actually see it is actually not even the full length of my afro. Like, you guys see it to where it's about like right here. But if I were to like braid my hair for a day and then take it down, my hair would be freaking huge. So trust me, like, the size of my fro that you guys are seeing is definitely not the full size. It's much, much bigger than how it looks. What's your real name? And from a scale from 1 to 69, how much of a Dragon Ball Z fan are you? As far as my real name goes, the only hint that I'm going to give you guys is my last name is actually Indakuba. I'm going to be honest. Like, I've said that on multiple Q&As. I said that on a live stream, actually multiple streams as well. So that's all you're getting from me. Like, my last name is Indakuba. But if I do grow my subscriber base to a point where I would feel comfortable with opening up like what my actual first name is with you guys, then I'll let you guys know. But yeah, my last name is actually Indakuba. And from a scale from 1 to 69, how much of a Dragon Ball Z fan am I? I'm just gonna put it like this. I'm currently wearing a Goku gi jacket, bruh. Like, I don't even think that numbers would actually describe how much of a Dragon Ball Z fan I am. Inakuba, will you finish the Dragon Ball Ultimate Tenkaichi 3 Let's Play? Congratulations for your 10,000 subscribers. Okay, so I'm guessing you mean my Tenkaichi 3 Let's Play. Now, the way how I put it, I'm pretty much saying, like, you know, it's finished because I went through like the GT saga and whatnot. But it's up to you guys. If you guys want me to do, I think I have the Dragon Ball saga and then the special saga, then let me know in the comment section below. Because if you guys are down for it, then I will definitely continue that Let's Play, because it's kind of technically done, but I don't really want to go into the Dragon Ball saga or the special saga unless you guys want to see it. So let me know in the comment section below. How old are you? I'm 22. Okay, bro, what is your first and latest anime you've watched so far? That's actually a really, really difficult question. By default, it probably would be Pokemon. I grew up with Pokemon like that. No, without a doubt, it is Pokemon. Definitely grew up with Pokemon first. After Pokemon was Dragon Ball Z, and it went from there. But yeah, Pokemon was first. And the latest anime that I'm watching right now is My Hero Academia. But since that's only 4 episodes deep, I'm gonna put that to the side and say that my true latest anime is actually watching the JoJo series. I already know Toasty's gonna get on my head about this, but yeah, I've been watching the JoJo series. I originally said that I wasn't interested in it, but after watching it, it's actually, you know, kind of flames, kind of sort of some flames. But yeah, the JoJo series, and then pretty much My Hero Academia afterwards. When is your next stream going to be? Honestly, bro, it might actually be later on today, or it might be sometime during the week. Because like I said earlier, I have 4 days off starting from the day that you guys see this video is my first day off. And it's 4 days off consecutively. So within those 4 days, I will definitely stream again either today or just sometime within the next few days. So now will you tell us your intro song? I get this question on a daily basis. I can't even fathom like all the comments that continuously say, Indakuba, what's your intro song? Indakuba, what's your intro song? Indakuba, what's your intro song? Oh my lord. But see, the thing about it is that I want to keep it like my own thing. Like, I want you guys to like always remember that when you hear this song, you think of my channel. So I kind of don't want to disclose it. But again, you guys have stuck around with me for the entire journey all the way up to 10K, or even some of you guys who probably just hopped in the building recently. So I guess, to be fair, I will finally tell you guys my intro song. My intro song is Faint Lawrence. That's it. I'm pretty sure you guys can search up on YouTube. So just search up Faint Lawrence. That is my intro song. Will you play the old generation DBZ games? Congratulations. Honestly, I have technically. Because of course I did Tenkaichi 3 recently. I've played Raging Blast 2. I've done a little bit of gameplay of the Budokai HD collection when that first came out. And if you guys want me to play more like classic Dragon Ball games, then let me know. Because if you guys want to see me play like Tenkaichi 2 or Raging Blast 1, Burst Limit, or maybe, okay, no, God forbid Budokai 2. But you guys get my point. If you guys want to see me play the older generation Dragon Ball Z games, let me know in the comment section below, because if there is enough reception, I will do it. Dragon Ball Z Extreme Mutoden has online now. Will you do more videos now? As a matter of fact, I have done a few videos. I've actually had a live stream with me playing online. I got bodied, I'm not gonna lie. But yeah, if you guys also want more Extreme Totem videos, let me know. Because more than likely, I will. It's just that I've fought... I'm gonna put it like this. The game is fun. Online mode is broken because everybody uses one character and does a certain move. It kind of killed me wanting to play online on Extreme Totem. But if you guys really do want it, then let me know in the comment section below and I will continue doing online mode on Extreme Totem. Q&A question. If you can be any character in any anime or manga, who would you be? To be honest, I don't even think I can answer that question. There's been so many like variations of anime that I've seen throughout the past few years that I could envision myself as being like any character from like a lot of anime. Like if I was in Dragon Ball Z, I would want to be Gohan. Like I've explained that reason so many times. Like if I was on Sword Art Online, I'd probably want to be Kirito. Like if I was on Naruto, I'd probably, actually who would I want to be? No, I know. If I was on Naruto, I'd probably want to be Kakashi because that's my boy. But there's a lot of anime, man. There's a lot of anime that I've seen. I can't really give you a solid answer on that just because I would not know specifically or give you a solid answer as to which character I would want to be out of all those anime the most. So yeah, those are all the questions that you guys have asked me. Again, thank you guys so much for even putting any type of comment in the comment section below. Let me know if you guys enjoyed this Q&A also, because if you guys do enjoy it, maybe I'll start doing more Q&As in the future. Who knows? But yeah, that is my Q&A for 10,000 subscribers. Again, guys, this is the true beginning, all right? This is the true road to see if I can make it up to the top or not. All right, so right now, the next road is road to 15K. Let's try and get it before the end of the year. And of course, if we get it by the end of the year or before then we're gonna raise the bar to 20K and then just go from there. But nonetheless, that is the end of this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. Of course, if you did, please like the video, share it with your friends, and subscribe to my channel. Also, don't forget to follow me on Twitter at IndieCooperYT. And for you mobile users, if you want to stay updated for all the videos that I upload, don't forget to ring my bell. And as always, thanks for watching. See you guys later.